Hello, Math30-1. Welcome to your last lesson on exponential and logarithmic functions. Today, we're going to learn how to graph logs. So to start off here, it's telling you to do this in your calculator. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to do this by hand and show you how I could think about by hand. First of all, I'm going to convert these into exponential equations. So remember, this is the same thing as 10 to the y is equal to x, right? We want to graph these and figure out what that value is. Now, right here, my y value is 1. So that's 10 to the 1 is equal to 10. That's interesting. So if I have, we're going to have right here for this graph, right? So that's 10. Now, another thing that's kind of neat is I want to find where it is on the y. So what about 10 to the negative 1? What's that going to give me? Well, that's when y is negative 1, right? My x value is going to be 1 over 10. So that's going to be so close to there, it's going to be over there. So my graph here is going to look something like, and then it still must cross here, because if I said 10 to the 0, that's equal to 1. Anything to the power of 0 is equal to 1, not 0. I don't know why I put a 0 there. And we just go like this, and it's going to look something like that. This is y is equal to log 10 to the x. Log 10 there, and we have an x, right? Now, let's take a look at the next one. We have 1/3. What does that 1/3 do? Okay, so once again, we have y, or we have 1 over 3 to the power of y is equal to x. Well, we know the y is 1, so that's 1 over 3 to the 1 is equal to 1 over 3. Huh, so when it's 1, my x value, when y is 1, my x value is going to be 1 over 3, which is somewhere over there, I'd say. It might even be there. Okay? Now, I want to know maybe when it's 1, when the y value is negative 1, so down here. So I'm going to put 1 over 3 to the power of negative 1 is equal to 3. So my y value is 1, negative 1, my x value is going to be 3. So I have x3 is right around there. Okay, so let's graph this. This is going to look something like this here. And, oh, it should cross there at 9. That was a bit off. So it looks like that. Okay, remember, these log graphs are just reciprocals of my exponential graph. Right? Because my x and y's are switched. That's it. So the exponential graph would kind of look this way. If I rotate it that way, hey, look, that's my exponential graph. This would be the positive, this would be the negative. So they're just kind of like that, right? Now let's take a look at the other one here. So we have 1/10. So that's 1 over 10 to the power of 1, because that's my y, is equal to what in x? 1 over 10. So that's going to be something way over there, okay? Then, I could also say 1 over 10 to the negative 1 is equal to 10. So, that's there. Oh, this is y is equal to 1 over 3. Oops, log 1 over 3 to the x. Okay, so let's try this out here. And we want 10, which is there, and 1/10. So let's draw this out. And it's going to look like this. And like that. That's interesting. So this is going to give me y is log, this is 1 over 10 x. All right, now it wants us to do this one here. Let's see if we could solve for these next two right here by themselves. Okay, so we want 5. So that means when y is 1, x is going to be 5, right? That's what we kind of figured out, because we have 5 to the 1 is going to be equal to 5. Alright, so we go here, 5, and there we go. We also know that 5 to the negative 1 is going to be 1 over 5. So when we're at negative 1, which is this height, we are 1 over 5, which is there. So my graph is going to look something like that, okay? And that is this one here. This is log 5x, okay? Pause. Sorry about the freezing there. So we have 1 over 5. So now let's take a look at, this is log right there, 5 to the x. Now let's take a look at this one here. So this is the same thing as we want when it's 1, we're going to get 1 over 5. So at 1, we get 1 over 5, which is somewhere over there. We have 5, when it's negative 1, right? So at negative 1, we have 5. At 1, we have 1 over 5. So this one's going to look, also goes in between there, still hits that. Because anything to the power of 0, right? So if I have 1 over 5 to the power of 0, anything to the power of 0 is equal to 1. That's why my x-intercept is always 1, because my y-value is 0 there, right? So we end up getting y is equal to log 1 over 5 to the x. So let's quickly solve this table to help sum up our rules. What is the domain for all of these? Well, it's kind of the range for my exponential graph. So it's just going to be x must be greater than 0. X is greater than 0. X must be greater than 0. And last one, x must be greater than 0. Right? For all of them, it's the same. We cannot have anything 0. It must be greater than 0. It's kind of like my range for my exponential graph, because these are inverses of each other. What is my range for this one? Well, that's going to be my domain of my exponential graph, similar to that, because and my range, it goes forever down and forever that way, or forever up. So y is an element of all real numbers. Y is an element of all real numbers. Now, what are my x-intercepts? My x-intercepts, there is no x-intercept, because my asymptote is that y is, or x is equal to 0. Sorry, is that x, is that x is equal to 0. So there are, my x-intercepts are all right here at 1. Sorry, just got a little bit messed up there. My x-intercepts are all 1. My y-intercepts, there are none, because my asymptote is that x is equal to 0, which is my x-axis, so there are no y-intercepts. My asymptote is that x is equal to 0, 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 right? Now remember in my exponential, it's y is equal to 0. There was a y-intercept, but no x-intercept. Everything's just switched. That's it. So what are the x-values when y is 1? Okay, so for this one, what's the x values and y is 1? It's going to be 3. This one here, it's going to be 10. This one here is going to be 1 over 3. This one here is 1 over 10. This one here is obviously going to have to be b. And that's it. All right, so I'm going to skip this part here and just go straight into this here and try and show you this equation. Now, why does this equation work? Well, if we look at these graphs here, we did have flips. Look at all the ones that are fractions. They are flipped in the x-axis. So this is kind of like saying y is being replaced, isn't it? So let's put this into exponential form. This first one here is like saying log, 1 over b, x is the same thing as saying 1 over b to the power of, let's call it y, is equal to x. Now, if I want to make this into b, how we normally have it, this is going to be to the negative 1. We have to do the integral thing, and we have x. So we get b to the negative y is equal to x. So basically, y got switched with negative y, right? That's essentially what happened there. That means a reflection in the x-axis. That is what happened. So normally we have b to the y is equal to x, so then this here, as soon as this is a fraction, that's the same as that. And remember, if I have put this back into log form now, this negative could go down in front. Okay? So here's a little thing. So y is replaced with negative y. And that's essentially what is happening. All right, so let's try this out here. What is happening here? Okay, and state this. So according to this equation here, log 1 over 4 to the x is the same thing as negative log 4x. Well, I know log 4x equals to 8. So then negative log 4x is going to equal to negative 8. There's my answer. Okay? Let's take a look and prove this. So this is the long way we're going to try and prove it. So prove the results. First, we're going to have, you know, log 4 base 4x is equal to 8. Well, that's the same thing if we put it in exponential form as 4 to the power of 8 is equal to x. Okay, and I'm just going to leave it like that. Now, let's look at this other one. I'm going to have log 1 over 4 x, and we know it's equal to something. Let's just say z. Okay? Well, now let's put this in exponential form. 1 over 4 to the z is equal to x. Alright? Now, I know x is equal to this from this here. X is equal to that. So I have 1 over 4 is equal to 4 to the power of 8. I just substituted this in for my x. So we know what x is equal to. Now, I'm looking at this. I need to get into the same base. So that's going to be 4 to the negative 1 is equal to z. So I end up getting 4 to the negative z is equal to 4 to the 8. So then we have negative z is equal to 8 because we have common bases. So then z is equal to negative 8. So that's the long way of doing it without using that law. So it is easy to do. It's not that difficult, but you can still do it. This is just a lot faster way using that law. We just kind of proved the law. All right, let's take a look at this next part 2 here. Now, we just want to complete the following statements using this graph here. Log 4 base 4x passes through the point 8 and, so let's look at log base 4x and point 8 right there. And that looks like 1.5, so that's 3 over 2 up, right? 1.5 approximately. Log 2 passes through 8, 3. Okay, and log 8 passes through 8, 1. It's only 1 up. This is 3. Okay, we have that done now. That's interesting. Now, the graph y is equal to log base 4x is a vertical stretch of y is equal to log 2x. Well, that's true. Look at the factors. This is going up. This gets stretched how much more? This gets stretched how much more? So log 4x is actually, if this is 3, that's 3 over 2, 1/2 of log x, log base 2x. Let's take a look at the other one. We have here the graph of log 8x is a vertical stretch of log 2x. How much? So here's 2x, 8x. Well, 8x and 2x, well, that this is 3, that's 1. It's going to be 8x is 1/3 of log 2x. Well, that makes things very interesting here. Okay, so state the factor and complete them there. So use the results above to determine the transformation which would graph this to log 64. Well, I look at this, 2 to the power of 8 is equal to 64. Here, 2 squared is equal to 4. 2 to the power of 3 is equal to 8. That's interesting. So this is the same thing as saying y is equal to log 2 to the 8x. So in other words, we want to the graph of this to that. What must we do? Well, I'm going to have a factor of, it's going to be a vertical stretch. So notice these here are all my vertical stretches. So this here is going to be a vertical stretch to go from here to here by a factor of 1 over 6. Okay? 1 over 6. Oops, sorry. This should be a 6. It's not 8. Okay? Now, complete the statement log 64 is equal to how many of that? Well, this is going to be 1/6 of that. This is 1/6 of that value. Okay? Does that help you get that? All right. Now let's take a look at my next part here. So we know that this is my vertical stretch. We could always change that to the n is 1 over n is my vertical stretch. So the graph y is equal to log base 3x to the graph y is equal to log base 8x. What is happening if we go from here to there? Well, 81, 3 to the 4 is equal to 81. So this is going to be, this here is log 3 to the 4 and x. So it's going to have to be, I can move that one in front, y is equal to 1 over 4 log 3x. So this here is a factor of 1/4. Vertical stretch of 1/4. Okay? By a factor, I ran over. Vertical stretch by a factor of 1/4 about the x-axis. Okay, so it's a vertical stretch of a factor of 1/4 about the x-axis. Now let's take a look at this one here. This time we're going from this to this. Huh. So this one here, we would have to square it. Y is equal to log, and then this is 4, this is log, y is equal to log, and this is 4 squared, and then x. So this here would have to go there, so I'd have to multiply that by 2. It's the exact opposite, going the opposite direction. So it's a vertical stretch by a factor of 2 about the x-axis. Okay? So complete the following. 81 is equal to, 1 over 4. This is equal to 2 multiplied by that. And that's it. Okay? Because that's squared, so this is equal to 2 times that. Alright? This here is 1/4 of that. This is double. This one here is double that. This is 1/4 of that. Okay? That's everything. Alright, let's take a look at example number 3. Okay, we have log base 5, x is equal to 6. State the value of log 125 of x. Alright, so now I'm going to first put this here and simplify this. This is the same thing as log 5 to the 3x. So that is 1 over 3 log 5 to the 3x. Well, I know 5 to the 3, or 5x, log 5 base x, because I can move this out there, that's 1 over 3. This is the same as 6. So that is going to be 1 over 3 multiplied by 6, which will give me a total of 2. Okay? Okay, so now I'm going to go over why this is like that. Because this here is like saying 125 to the power of y is equal to x, basically, right? Because it's equal to something. Now, this is also like saying 1 or 5 to the power of 3 is equal to y, which is equal to x. So that's like saying 5 to the 3y is equal to x. Well, there, in my original, was 5y is equal to x. Y got replaced with 3y. Therefore, if y is getting replaced with 3y, what ends up happening? We have a compression, or so what ends up happening is we have a factor of 1 over 3. So that's essentially what's happening to help you understand if I put it in exponential form. So let's now prove this by converting this form. So we're going to first let, I'm going to have log 5 to the x is equal to 6. So that's like saying 5 to the power of 6 is equal to x. So there we go. We know what x is equal to. We've isolated x. It's equal to that. Now we're going to simplify this one here. That's like saying, we're going to say log 125 to the x is equal to, I'm going to call it, we're going to use z again. Okay? Now, this is also like saying 125. Actually, I'm going to call this y. Okay, so we could look at it in terms of y. So we have 125 to the y is equal to x, right? Now, we have 125, now we know what, x is equal to. X is equal to 5 to the 6. 5 to the 6 is equal to x. We're going to plug that into x. So all I have here, 125 to the y is equal to 5 to the 6. Now, in order to solve this, I need common bases. So 5 to the 3y is equal to 5 to the 6. So we have 3y is equal to 6. Y is equal to 2. And there we go. That is now solved. And we just proved it just a bit longer. Okay, so here we go. It says, here's the graph shown. Okay, write the transformation associated with each of the following and sketch the graph on the grid. So we want 2x. So here, y is being replaced with 1 over 2y, right? So that is a factor of 2. Everything has to be multiplied by 2. So if this is there, this will now be there. Okay? What other point is going to change? This point here is going to be changed to there. And this still must be the same. So my graph is going to kind of look like, well, this point here is going to be down there, right? Because everything's twice as far away. So my graph is going to kind of look like, whoops, like this. And this is y is equal to, we have here, what is it? 2 log 3x. So this is a stretch by a factor of 2. Okay? Now right here, we have x is being replaced with x minus 2. So x is replaced with x subtract 2. So that's going to be a, and every time we do this, from what we learned from our transformations, this is a shift of a factor of 2 about the, this here is a shift of 2 right. Okay? So this graph now is going to be shifted to right. So this is going to go there. Okay? This point here, this point here is going to go to right, which is around right there. We have this point here is going to go to right. It's going to be there. This point here is going to be somewhere over there. So my graph, my asymptote, is going to be right here. Put a dotted line for the asymptote. And my graph is going to look something like that. Okay? And this is y is equal to log, or in base 3, x subtract 2. All right. Now let's take a look at my last one right here. Okay? Huh. We have y being switched with y plus 2, because I could add 2 to both. So this whole graph here is shifted 2 down. So this is down here now. This point here goes 2 down. This point here is going to go 2 down. And which point is it? This point here, or this point here, is going to go 2 down. So my graph is going to look like, I already lost track. Yep, there, there. The graph is going to look something like that. Okay, it's shifted 2 down, so that's y is equal to log base 3 x minus 2. Shifted 2 down. Okay, now, do any of the above transformations result in a change of the origin of the domain and range? Well, yes, this one here does. The horizontal shift. Changes my domain. Okay? State the equation of the asymptote for each in part A. So my asymptote here is, well, x is equal to 0. This one here is x is equal to 2. This next one here is x is equal to 0. Alright? So my asymptote only changes for this one. And that is what my shift, the horizontal shift, changes the domain. And that's what we found out. And it changed my asymptote as well. This value here becomes my asymptote. Alright? So, here's your last investigation. I'll leave that up to you to do.